Good evening. It's wonderful to have you all here. Well, afternoon, I'm sorry. Good afternoon. It's wonderful to have you here for the final portion of our Showcase of Bands weekend. We had started with a wind ensemble concert last night. We had three high schools perform this afternoon, and now we will have the WIU Concert Band followed by the WIU Honor Band. It's been awesome. It's been a great weekend. So without further ado, please welcome the director of the WIU Concert Band, Professor Anneliese Land.
Thank you. the moment of fear. Will the microphone work? Of course it will. Welcome to Western Illinois University. I am Anneliese Land. I'm on music education faculty here, and it is my delight to have worked with these students this semester and to have all of you fabulous honor band students. We've had high school students all over campus the past couple of days, and the energy that we feel in our music buildings is second to none. We have future Leathernecks here in the hall with us, and many students on stage have shared that they performed in the showcase of bands when they were in high school, and here they are. Can we have hands of those of you? Some of you mentioned that a couple of days ago. It's truly a delight to see all of us come full circle and to welcome you to this musical event. So moving forward, part of the showcase of bands experience is to bring a guest clinician to work with all students who are here on campus, and it is my delight to welcome to the stage for this next piece Dr. Matt McCutchen from the University of South Florida. Can you please welcome him to the stage?
Thank you. It is a real pleasure to be here and a treat. I want to talk just a brief amount about the next piece we're playing, Good Night, Dear Heart. The composer is a choral composer and a well-known choral composer. And he had a brother and sister-in-law who had been trying for many years to have children and weren't successful, so they finally decided to adopt a child from Ethiopia. And they had a 4-month-old child that was promised to them, and they received word that the child was sick. And as there was nothing they could do, they prayed fervently. Child got a little bit better, and then a few weeks later, the child died. And the piece essentially is written to try to portray the grief that you can feel for a child that, or somebody that you've never met. And before I was a parent, I wouldn't have understood that at all. And now I completely understand it. And as do, I'm sure, all the parents in the audience. So, and this wasn't even his child, it was his brother's child. So he says he normally doesn't write about personal feelings like this, but he was just so moved that as a choral composer, the first thing he wanted to do was find the appropriate text. And he searched through all normal places and remembered that in his childhood home, there was the graveyard where Mark Twain's 24-year-old daughter, who died unexpectedly, was buried. And I think this really shattered Mark Twain. And on her graveside is written, "Warm summer sun, shine kindly here. Warm southern winds, blow softly here. Green sod above, lie light, good night, dear heart, good night, good night." So you should go home tonight and Google the choral version of this because it is stunningly beautiful. And then he redid it himself for band because there were some things that he wanted to get in. So for example, in the middle, the instruments stop and you just hear they blow into the instruments. That's the warm summer wind that's blowing. Percussion and harp start playing, and that's the mobile that was over the child's bassinet that she never got to hear.
Do I need to turn this off? Thank you.
This next piece takes just a little bit of introduction. We hope you enjoy it, and it is something maybe a little different than you've experienced before. So pop music is not, in fact, the pop music that we know and love. It's a quirky title to describe what is one of Alex Shapiro's lovely works that is for band and recorded track. So you will hear an additional musician pumped through the speakers that you see next to you, which is crucial to the success of this performance. Additionally, so that we stay with this performer, I will wear a click track along with the track to make sure we're all together. I'll tell you just a little bit about the piece, give you a little bit of context. So Alex Shapiro got her compositional training at Juilliard School in Manhattan on the East Coast, moved over to the West Coast, started composing for films and in commercial music in LA. And ultimately, around the rise of the digital age, for those of you youngsters, it had already happened before you existed, but as computers started to take hold and we explored creating sound on computers, she kind of took hold of that movement and kind of trademarked her sound being concert band with recorded tracks. So she's written several pieces like this. Now, this specific piece was written quite recently, and I'd like to give you just a little bit of the program note here. So, pop music celebrates dedicated band students who were unable to do something that they love, gather, rehearse, and perform for an extended period of time due to precautions against the coronavirus pandemic. We all remember this. A circus-like atmosphere often accompanies the seriousness of our times, and a little clown-like silliness may be good for a much-needed laugh after years of uncertainty in which the only constant has been the lack of constancy. The unprecedented times that we all heard about a lot. So as for the title, pop music, it's an ironic nod to all of our unmet expectations. This piece is neither pop music in the traditional sense, nor does a single balloon explode, at least not intentionally. So our students will also delight you with some balloon sounds live in addition to playing other instruments. And we hope that you enjoy our rendition of pop music. All right, well, if you've ever or had on your bucket list to see a balloon performed live, you've seen several now, so you can check that one off when you get home. One more brief note as we move forward here. We have two pieces remaining. The other exciting portion of the Showcase of Bands is that we welcome a guest composer each year. It's critical that students get the opportunity to work with the people who write the music that they play. And we're thrilled to have these composers listen to what we've been doing and give us comments and feedback and get to have that interaction live in the rehearsal space. So each of our bands throughout this weekend has performed a work of Ryan George's, and we will perform his Visionaries. Give a little wave, Mr. Ryan George over here. Thank you. It's been a real joy to have him on campus and work with him, and we hope you enjoy Visionaries.
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to torture the mic people one more time, I'm sorry. No band concert is complete without a march, right? It's where we started, and it is rich in our tradition, our history. We're going to send you off at the march, and we're so excited after the march to make a quick set change and invite our fabulous honor band up on the stage, so stay tuned for that. Thank you again for being here, and we will end our portion with Pentland Hills.
Thank you. Welcome to the University Union. Serving as the center of campus life, the Union is a great place to hang out with friends for lunch, meet with a student organization, attend events, or take advantage of one of our lounge spaces to study or relax in between classes. The University Union is here for you.
University, you will explore your talents in a place where you belong. No matter where you come from, no matter what you want to do, we believe in where your potential will take you. Learn more at wiu.edu.
At Western Illinois University, limits are meant to be pushed. Because the best change happens when people think in new and unexpected ways. At WIU, you'll experience a world where your presence matters, where your ideas take flight, and your determination opens the door to possibility. At WIU, we create a world that's brand new.
At Western Illinois University, each student brings their own unique background and unlimited potential. You work side by side with compassionate, encouraging faculty who connect you to personalized learning experiences and give you the opportunities to map your own future. Your potential, our purpose.
At Western Illinois University, Leathernecks don't just blend in. Our purple stands out. Our students are innovative, creative, and resilient. At WIU, there is limitless potential, with campuses in Macomb, the Quad Cities, and online. Visit wiu.edu/potential to become a Leatherneck and get an education that stands out.
Grit. It's that thing inside of you that ignites passion and empowers you to envision a world full of possibility. At Western Illinois University, Leathernecks are made with this grit. It starts here, in this field, in this room, on this court, and in this lab. We refuse to blend in because our purple stands out.
At Western Illinois University, Leathernecks don't just blend in. Our purple stands out. Our students are innovative, creative, and resilient. At WIU, there is limitless potential, with campuses in Macomb, the Quad Cities, and online. Visit wiu.edu/potential to become a Leatherneck and get an education that stands out.
This is it, the finale. We're grateful to have everyone here for our final concert of the Showcase of Bands weekend. This is a wonderful group that has grown from a lot of individuals who didn't even know each other coming into this for the most part to just a really nice musical ensemble. And I know you're going to love this concert that they're about ready to do. Let me throw out to you that we have loved having them here over the weekend. How many of you are parents? Let me see the parents. Yes. Band directors? Yes. Let's give the band directors a round of applause for everything they do. Yes. Wonderful, wonderful people. Parents, thank you for being here, for supporting your children, and for sending them here with us this weekend. We would love to have them come back and visit and be a part of things as much and as often as they can. One thing that Dr. McCutchen and I talked to them about was, and I said specifically, is use Western as an opportunity right now while you're in high school to explore options about music later in life. So come here, take a lesson with one of our faculty. They would love to sit down and I'll speak for them. I hope that's okay, but I'm sure that they would love to sit down and do a lesson. Come, if you're thinking about maybe teaching in music, then come sit in on a music education class. If you're thinking about doing music business, music therapy, come spend the day here. We would love to put together a personal itinerary for you and have you come out and just explore those options. Talk to people that are doing it, talk to people that are students, and that sort of thing. So please, 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 don't ever hesitate to use us. We want to be a part of that decision-making process. And of course, we'd love to have you come to Western. So without further ado, we will introduce now the WIU Honor Band under the direction of my good friend, Dr. Matt McCutchen. Please welcome Dr. McCutchen to the stage. Thank you.
one of the things that we remember him the most for was that he was collecting folk songs when this was, when we were first starting to have instruments that could do this. So you think, okay, maybe I'll pull up my cell phone and I'll collect it. We're talking about things that like horses had to carry around, so because they were so big. And so he's going all over England and he's collecting folk songs. And the interesting thing about this was that some of the folk song singers first didn't want to sing to them. This is how they made their living, so they didn't want to share this. But take it one step further, some of them would sing into this giant box, and then they'd hear their voice, and they really thought, I mean, it really freaked them out. They thought that their part of their soul had gone into this box, which makes no sense to us. But imagine if you had never heard your voice before, and there's this giant contraption, and you sing, and then it sings back to you. So Granger gathered folk songs from all over England, and he wrote hundreds and hundreds of arrangements. He would write the same tune for all sorts of different things. And this particular one is called There Was a Pig Went Out to Dig. Okay? It's a Christmas tune. It's incredibly complex. There was a pig went out to dig on Christmas Day. On Christmas Day, there was a pig went out to dig on Christmas Day in the morning. There was a cow went out to plow on Christmas Day. And it goes on and on and on and on like this. Okay? So it's kind of nonsense and cute. And a former student of mine found a choral version of this and said, this needs to be done for band. So he arranged it, sent it to me. I played with my wind ensemble. I sent back to him, can you do this? Can you do this? And he sent it back to me 2 weeks ago. This is the first time this particular arrangement has ever been heard. And we're pleased to do Granger's There Was a Pig Went Out to Dig. Little dances that he was inspired in with South America. great. You should watch it. It's really, really wonderful. And then about two-thirds of the way through, he reads a letter from a Civil War soldier, my very dear Sally, the soldier had sent to his girlfriend, I think it's his girlfriend at home, and the letter made it home, but the soldier never did. And he wrote this, and as the documentary, as they're reading this and showing all the pictures, they're playing this particular piece. Now, it's funny because the piece is only about 20 years old. It has nothing to do with the Civil War whatsoever, but it feels like this. So Ashokan, there's a strings camp up in the Ashokan Mountains, and the man who runs it, at the very end of the camp, he's a fiddler, and he gets together, and his wife plays guitar, and there's one other instrument that I'm forgetting right now, and they write this very, very simple piece, and they put all the strings players out in front of them, and this is the way they say goodbye to them. And I heard it years ago, and was just, when you're in my profession, you listen to a lot of music, and if I'm going to be completely honest, you forget a lot of music the wrong way. And there's certain pieces that you can remember very vividly where you heard them the first time, and to me, this is one of them. I think it's just absolutely beautiful, and we hope you enjoy Ashokan Farewell.
Thank you. So, Doc, which is a great time to go on sabbatical when you're about to host a festival. We host one like this, and you think you might possibly know how much work it is? You're not even close. And for the effort that they put through, his students who have been wonderful, the faculty here has been wonderful. It's a class act all the way around. We're really, really grateful. Thank you for having me, and it's so good to spend some time with you again. On top of that, the whole format is really brilliant. Alfred Watkins over here is, I would say, arguably, but it's not really arguable, the best high school band director probably in the last 50 years. I mean, we're talking like Sousa Watkins, right? Sousa never in high school. And to get to watch him work has been extraordinary. I've gotten to do it many times, and I brought him down to South Florida, and will continue to do so. So the experiences that you're providing. And then Ryan George, I'm going to introduce to you in just a minute because we're going to play his piece. Dr. Thomas, what a great event. Thank you for all of your efforts. Thank you for all of this, and we really do appreciate it. I want to say a few more thank yous. Band directors, I know he mentioned you already. Would you please raise your hand, band directors? So, parents, these are the only people on the planet who love your children as much as you do. So another round of applause for the band directors. We've got freshmen who are still learning what buttons to push down. Came together Thursday night. I went home and got my plane ticket early so I could leave Friday morning. Thought, oh, this is going to be bad. Stuck around. They have gotten better every day, every step. And I just want to say that we hear so much about what's wrong with our country, wrong with our educational system, and wrong with our students and our children. I think they represent everything that is right with our country and right with our educational system and right with our families and our students. They are bright, driven, eager to please, hardworking, and I have thoroughly enjoyed every minute. So a round of applause for the students. We have one piece left, and to introduce it, I'm going to bring the composer, Ryan George, up to talk about Cafe 512.
I too want to echo what he said. It's been a joy to work with this ensemble the last few days and to be a part of this. And thank you to WIU and Dr. Thomas for inviting me to be a part of this. So Cafe 512 was a piece that I wrote for a band in Austin, Texas that was about to go to the Midwest Band and Orchestra Convention in Chicago about 12 years ago. And the director said, I want something passionate that's dance-like. And so when you combine passion with dance, you get tango. And so it prompted an idea, and in wanting to kind of keep this piece connected to this band's Austin roots, I took the area code of Austin, which is 512, and built a thematic idea and a motif that you'll hear quite a bit based on a five-note, one-note, and two-note grouping. So this is Cafe 512.